Good afternoon, Akronomist.
Good afternoon, Mr. Cassie.
Even though that will be probably the final time that you will hear that from me, I would love to see you whenever possible on a day off to come down and visit us here at the little golf hall. It was written in Jeremiah chapter 29, verses 11 and 13, where if any of you have had the pleasure of being in Mr. C's office, you will see this posted on my wall. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope in a future. Then you will call on me and come and pray to me, and I will listen to you. You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all of your heart. Now, if you think about that, a lot of you might think prosperity is wealth. And I want to remind you that there's more to prosperity than just our wealth. And we have learned that through our years here at Economics. Some of the things that we also have learned through these past months have been perseverance and wisdom and respect and responsibility and faith and tolerance and service and courage and creativity through some of our virtues of the month. The key, I feel, to prosperity is the state of our soul. And also, in knowing Mr. Cassie, who is a very passionate person when it comes to the sport of baseball. And I know that with life and with baseball, and there are many miracles that have been expressed throughout that. We don't know what the future holds for you. None of us can foresee your future, but we want to do so and see in front of us your potential, the potential each one of you has to be the best that you can be. When you leave here and you enter the next stage of your education, be kind to others, friends, be kind to your family, be kind to your classmates, which hopefully one day you will realize are your friends and your family. And depend on your God for your strength. When it comes to the baseball lifestyle, if you pass by my office, sometimes you will see quotes and things like that hanging off my door or my wall. One that I ran across most recently that I had posted for a few days was that your play on the field does not define you as a person, whether you go 4-for-4 or 0-for-4. Whether you are the starting pitcher or a defensive replacement, that role and how you play it never defines who you are. What defines you is how you treat your what defines you is how you treat your teammates, how you decide to tackle the role that you are given, and the attitude and work ethic that you choose every single day. Knowing that, and knowing that there are many tasks that we are given, such as homework, that we sometimes don't enjoy, the effort and the knowledge that comes out of that is everlasting. Finally, the lesson based on our growth mindset is our perseverance. Our time on earth will be difficult and a challenge at times, or most of the time. What you have to understand about these challenges, failures, struggles, is that there is ultimately a lesson that can be taken from the situation to help us become the best form of us. Don't be afraid to fail or trying something that you don't think that you would be good at. It is this fear of failure that will prevent you from being the best version of us. So dream big, set goals. Don't let anyone make you believe that you aren't capable of doing anything that you want to do. Because ultimately that decision lies within you. And how hard you are willing to work to achieve. I wish you the best for each and every one of you as you complete your time here at Akron Elementary and begin the next 6 years of your secondary education. God bless.